If we have editor scripts within the assets folder and try to build our game, Unity will throw an error as it cannot find their namespaces or types. That's because our editor files shall not go into our game build, as our game doesn't really need them. Thankfully, Unity has something called special folder names. They are simply reserved folder names with specific behaviors, and one of them is exactly what we need, the editor folder. Unity knows that any file that's within this folder should run as an editor script and not a runtime script. Note that this folder is not tied to the root folder, meaning we can create it anywhere we want as well as how many times we want, allowing us to have multiple editor folders in different places. Of course, we can also create folders inside, allowing for a better organization of our editor files. With our editor scripts inside the editor folder, we can now build our game without any error, as editor scripts are not included in builds. Do note that the editor will work without the scripts being inside the editor folder. It will just not be possible to build the game. That's the main behavior of the editor folder and one that you should know about. But there are a few things that we need to keep in mind. Any script inheriting from MonoBehaviour that goes inside the editor folder will no longer be able to be attached as a game object component. If we want to still be able to attach that script as a game object, we will need to leave it outside of the editor folder, but attach the EditorOnly tag to the game object that uses it. This tag simply tells Unity that the game object shouldn't be included in the game build. And that's it for the editor folder. We can still make use of it for the editor GUI utility load method, but I'll talk about that in my resources special folder tutorial, so feel free to check that video when it is out. There is also a compilation order to keep in mind when placing the editor folder inside other specific special folders, which simply means it won't be able to reference certain files. I'll leave a few links in the description if you want to dive deeper into that. Feel free to subscribe if you haven't, or follow me on Twitter for updates on my first game and future tutorials. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial, and see you in the next one.